With the availability of version 6.6 for RIVAGE PM series, the DM7 and DM3 range of digital mixers can now have their internal head amps remotely controlled. It means these smaller all-in-one mixers can also be used as I/O racks, reducing the equipment list on stage or in an orchestra pit. Let's see how to get the devices mounted, connected, and controlled. I shall begin with the DM3, which needs to be a Dante version. It's a little simpler to set up due to having fewer channels and other options. On the DM3 screen, open the Setup menu and the Dante Setup. Give it a unit ID that is unique among the mixing desks in the network. Though it can be the same number as some other different types of device, such as I/O racks and wireless mic receivers. Dante patching will need to be handled either from Dante controller software or from the RIVAGE PM console, as the DM3 Dante patch facility is limited to working with TIO and RIO units and DZRD and DXS XLF series powered loudspeakers. Now, of course, the DM3 Dante port must be connected to the same physical network as the HY Dante card in the RIVAGE PM series DSP engine and with the same network address settings. If they are both set to auto DHCP, that is perfect. On the RIVAGE PM console, mount a new Dante device and find the DM3 in the online device list. Once mounted, the on-screen status indicator for DM3 will change from discovering to connecting, synchronizing, and then controllable. After that, the HA gain and phantom power controls for the 16 inputs will be available. Do note that the gain range is a little different for DM3. It's limited to a minimum of 0 and a maximum of plus 64, whereas DM7 series and the RIO units extend from minus 6 to plus 66. Now let's get working with the DM7, which has similar input and output characteristics to an RIO D2 rack. Open the I/O device menu and the Dante setup screen. The Dante control ID needs to be different from the one used by the RIVAGE PM console. Only 4 consoles with Dante control IDs are allowed in one system. Any additional console will need their ID to be turned off, meaning its own HA cannot be controlled remotely, and it cannot remotely control other HA devices. DM7 uses a different mechanism for HA control than DM3, though they may look similar. DM7 has the advantage of working both on the primary and secondary Dante networks if you're using them with redundancy, whereas HA control with DM3 will only operate on the primary Dante network. Anyway, with the ID set on DM7, open the RIVAGE PM system config. Find the right HY slot screen and mount a new device. Find the DM7 or DM7 Compact in the online device list. Highlight it and touch OK. And then you'll be able to watch the HA controls change their status from discovering to connecting, synchronizing, and then controllable. And now the HA controls can be adjusted on the screen using the encoders below. To bring the HA control to the input channels, the Dante patch needs to be made. In fact, three stages of patching must be checked. The DM7 or DM3 output patch, the Dante patch, and then the Rivage PM input patch. Let's go back to the DM7 first. Its Omni inputs need to be patched directly to the Dante outputs. So open the patch menu and look at the output port screen. Select Dante and touch the source for Dante output port 1. Note that Dante outputs 1 to 16 must be used in the case of DM7 compact, or 1 to 32 for the larger DM7. Using higher numbered Dante output ports will not work for HA control, so reserve them for other output channels. Set the sequential patch to 16 or 32, depending on the size of the console, and touch Omni 1 to make the patches. If using a DM3, find the patch in the Setup menu and open the Output patch screen. Here, connect IN 1 to Dante 1 and IN 2 to Dante 2, and so on. Note that there are only 16 output channels for Dante, so you might use all of them by connecting the inputs. Patching the input ports to Dante like this is sending the audio post-headamp but pre-processing. Before moving back to the Rivage PM console, quickly check the word clock status of DM7 or DM3 is matching with regard to source and sample rate. Remember, the sample rate has to match for the Dante patching to function. Back on the Rivage PM console, find the Dante input patch in the system config and HY slot screen. Make a diagonal patch from the DM7 inputs 1 to 32 or from 1 to 16 to the relevant Dante inputs of the HY144D card. Then, in the patch menu for inputs, make sure the HY144D input ports are patched to the correct input channels. View these input channels on the overview screen or the selected channel screens to access the HA controls as normal. Now the DM7 or the DM3 can be used as an I/O rack. Remember to disable with recall in the HY slot config screen if you don't want a scene recall from the Rivage PM to reset the input gains of the remote mixer, in case the smaller mixer has its own operator who needs to manage those settings. DM7 series allows the use of GC, that is gain compensation, allowing the A gain setting to be adjusted without affecting the signal level traveling through the Dante network to the remote devices. In that case, use the console's digital gain to adjust the signal level independently from the other consoles in the system. Note that gain compensation is not available with DM3, but there is independent digital gain control present in the channel strips. So now you know how to mount and control the head amps within the mixers, you'll be able to design and manage more versatile and flexible audio systems. Though, before you go, please watch the other videos about the new features included in RIVAGE PM version 6.6.